Thank you for tuning in to the World Builder's Anvil, episode 314, The Relaxation Accord, or as I like to call it, relaxing, according to Jeff.
Don't know where to start building your fantasy world?
Do you need more? Does it make sense?
Forget any worries and become a crafter of imagination.
This is the place where we will prime your mind.
Now, it's time to heat up the forge.
Break out the mithril ingots and hammer.
Welcome to the World Builder's Anvil. I'm Jeffrey W. Ingram.
And I'm Michael Miller.
Let's sup from the mug of Java and build. Overcomplicating things as usual, my name is Jeffrey W. Ingram.
And so in need of relaxation, I am Michael Miller.
Yes, so I thought we needed a system to relax people.
And we're so anal about this stuff that we need to create a system to not do things.
By the time this 30-minute episode is over, you will have a 3,000-sheet spreadsheet in order to relax properly.
We make systems to do things, and now we're making systems to not do things.
That's true.
It's true.
and so, if you're like Michael, and you're most people, you're like, what the heck is a relaxation accord? You know what relaxation is. You know accords like sort of like a peace treaty.
Do we have an accord?
Do we have an accord? No.
And what I'd said to Jeff that tickled him is I was like, the name of this episode is The Relaxation Accord. And he's like, yes. And I'm like, that's what I call my new Honda.
It's a nice way of saying it has no pick up and go.
it's actually pretty nimble, zippy. Surprisingly. Yeah, it's pretty zippy considering it's like a 20-year-old car.
Oh, wow. So it's living up to the Honda name, huh?
It really is.
Yeah.
I mean, it's got low mileage on it. It's a 2002, so it's 18 years old, but it's only got 87,000 miles on it.
Yeah, that's really low. I know. It's like I had an accountant mechanic who he had a Accord for years, and he actually did a commute from Worcester to Windsor Locks every day.
Every day?
He owned a business.
For those of you that
he owned a business in Windsor Locks, yeah.
For those of you that don't know these areas, that's more than an hour drive.
Yes. His daily commute was over an hour. That was halfway between where, essentially Worcester is about halfway between where him and his wife worked. He worked in Windsor Locks. She worked in Boston. So they moved to Worcester, Mass., which is about in between. Technically miles closer to Boston, but not time-wise.
Not yet. Yeah. Trying to get to Boston in the morning traffic is awful. Yeah.
So here we are with the relaxation accord, and this is something where actually my wife and I were actually recently working on this for ourselves. And the problem is, especially in life, as you do more adulting things, especially when you have kids, you push off things for yourself further and further. And then all of a sudden you realize you're not doing anything, you know, that is relaxing. And then, you know, you work really hard. And then you get to a point where you burn out. And then, you know, you sit and you eat Cheetos and play Skyrim for 322 hours straight, according to my calculator. And then you go, oh, crap, I'm really far behind because I just played Skyrim for 322 hours straight. And you go back to working for the next 700 hours. And then the cycle just keeps repeating itself. And the thing is, you really don't get much. You get a lot less done than you would if you just kind of spaced it out and, one, gave your mind time to relax to other things. Doing some of the things you can enjoy will actually give your brain the chance to do the things you want it to in a shorter period of time. I'm actually reminded there's Don John is, I believe, a surfing company. They make supplies for surfing, like surfboards and stuff and beachwear. And it was growing really fast and it was becoming like a brand new sensation. And the CEO who started this firm to make beach supplies so he could spend more time at the beach realized he was working, you know, like 20 hours a day. And he essentially spent some time, worked with his team and said, you know what, we're going to send out a notice to everyone in the firm and, you know, in this large growing corporation and tell them that they need to figure out how to do their job in 4 hours or we don't want them anymore. We don't want them to work 8 hours. We don't want them to work more than 4 hours. We want them on the beach. And, you know, and the thing is, there's actual real proof that even when you work 8 hour days, you're not working 8 hour days. You're at work for 8 hours a day. You're not working 8 hours a day. And, You know, it's just the way the brain works, your energy. Just humans weren't really designed to work the way we work now. And, you know, we haven't had enough time to adapt to work this way. So we need relaxation to avoid escapism, which to me is like a burnout thing where, like, literally all you're doing is playing video games or watching TV, and you're not doing the things you want to do. You're just doing things so you're not doing the things you don't want to do. Mm. And, you know, the reason I call it an accord is if you're an adult, you probably have at least one other person in your life, but it might just only be you, but you still have to promise yourself sometimes to do the right thing, to take care of yourself in order to get along in life with yourself. But obviously if you have a spouse and kids, it involves them too. So that is a relaxation accord, and kind of it's, as I just implied there, it's just involves the people in your life, your immediate life. Your boss, you're not making the accord with, right? He's not going to come up with an arrangement probably that will allow you to do your job in 4 hours a day, unless you happen to work for that corporation. And I could have got the name of the corporation wrong. It might have been a different one, but it was definitely a beach company.
I've heard of this before, though. There was another company that it definitely wasn't this beach company that you're referring to. It was some other one that I'd heard of where they did the exact same thing where they – I forget how they trimmed it down. I don't think they trimmed it down to 4 hours, but they definitely trimmed it down very much smaller than it was. And they were like, get your work done in this amount of time. Or they might have even have just gone to the employees and said, how much time do you need in a day to finish the amount of work that we expect you to, you know, complete in a day? And – I think everyone might have made their own schedule, so certain people's jobs required 5 hours and some, you know, only three or whatever it was. But as long as they were, you know, meeting deadlines and upholding their quota, whatever that was for, you know, productivity, they were allowed to go.
Okay. I'm going to throw this out there for the people who are listening to this episode. I just cut out from – didn't quite drop, but I lost my internet connection. They're working on the internet outside my house. So I might get cut off at times. It obviously was a clean cut because Michael didn't notice. So
I didn't notice. Yeah. So you may need to take both of our recorded files.
Yeah, we're going to definitely want to just upload this one when you're done with it and I can bring it
down.
Yeah.
I don't even know if I remember how to do that. You haven't done it in so long. Mm-hmm. You might have sent me a link or something.
Well, all you did was put up on Google Drive and sent me the link. That's how you were doing it before. So
you may need to remind me. Anyway.
Okay.
So, what would be your first step for creating an accord? Like, would it be something, some self-reflection on what you want in your life?
Yeah, most definitely is, you know, I think the first thing is you have to know is, you know, kind of what you're doing, you know, and part of that is knowing, you know, sort of taking a schedule of your time. And we've done this in the past on the show. We've talked about time budget. This mm-hmm. is something that I do occasionally. I budget my time because it is my most precious commodity. It crushes money,
me too.
Hands down. You know, because I could make more money if I work more hours, but then I have less time to do the things that I was working to get money for. So what's the effing point, you know? Mm. And you got to know what you're spending your time on. And what you wish you could spend time on. Now, for me, it's playing more games with my friends, right? I got to get a game going. It might be D&D, it might be GURPS, but I'm going to have to put a game together soon. Because it's been years since I've really ran a game, you know?
Yeah, it's been years since I've played. I don't think I've played since last time you and I were at a table together.
Yeah, wow. Yeah, which is sad for both of us. it really is.
Well, you know, life trumps.
Life trumps, but you know. Sometimes, you know, we got to look to put things together to make them work again. So the idea is one, you know, is once again, how do you spend your time? And trust me, a lot of it's wasted. And, you know, when you sit there and you go, okay, I need 8 hours a day to sleep. And I'm a firm believer, 7 to 9 hours, unless you can get a doctor's note telling you otherwise, you need 7 to 9 hours. You might be unlucky not be able to sleep that long because of other issues. I know when I have pain issues, I have trouble sleeping. I know Michael has some insomnia issues, which might or might not be related to pain, or it could be that and other stuff. I don't know. I just know you do have sleep issues. Most people do at times in their life have sleep issues. But you should schedule literally 7 to 9 hours a week. Like some of the people I know are really successful who've come from nothing are very regimented with their sleep and guarantee they have it no matter what. That's why really good athletes are very regimented in their lives, at least during season when they're active as an athlete. You really need a good grasp on your schedule. And Yeah, I have to make sure that there's a link available to the time budget still for people. So if you go to Gardool.com/time, you'll be able to just download that. It's a little Excel file. You can upload it into Google Sheets if you want to, but it's just a quick little place. It'll track the time for you. It'll tell you how much hours you have left. And sometimes you're going to wonder, wait, if I feel like I have no time, but this thing is telling me I have 14 hours left, what's going on? You know what that is? That's you playing bubble games on your phone or going through Facebook for the 500th time of a day. And then you just have to determine, do you want to relax? Because trust me, being in your newsfeed and Facebook is not relaxing. It's a pull. It's a desire. It was like, you know, it's like someone smoking. You know, you're just going back because you need that fix. I hate when I make myself work like that. Okay. Now I have to make sure I have a page up there, hopefully. Moving on. When you're in a household, you're trying to make an accord with other people. They need to have some accounting, too, of what they wish they could do. You know, so it's like my wife has stuff she wished she couldn't do. It's like I bought her a piano. Well, not really. It's like a weighted keyboard. And a program that will literally help her learn to play the piano. And I bought it for, I think, a couple years ago. And she uses it and then runs out and stops using it for long periods of time because she's so busy. That's one of the things she wishes she could do. You know, she has other things that she wants to do, too. Some are artistic. Some are I personally think, goofy. I hate to say that. And I'm sure she thinks a lot of things I wanted to do is goofy. It's not the point. The point isn't what the other person is doing in the time. It's what do they wish they're doing. Because ultimately, you're trying to come up with a win-win arrangement with them and say, hey, if you give me these slots of time, I'll give you these slots of time, and we're not doing dishes. We're not doing laundry. We're not doing anything but something relaxing to ensure that our brain gets a chance to have a break too. But really, you know, you're trying to figure out what is your work time, what's your family time, and what's your free time? What's your hobby time?
One of the difficulties that I've been having with my new job is the work home life balance because of the amount of time that it's taking from me based on the drive time and what have you. And also now I'm finding myself, I think I'm going to start doing some homework because I have, or at least until I get better at what I'm doing. So like after we're done recording today, I'm going to sit down with a blueprint, and I have to like really get more familiar with this blueprint since I'm running the job. And that's
the one you studied probably to do an exam before, but haven't really done since you've studied for it.
Well, I certainly took blueprinting classes when I was in school, and I certainly have worked with blueprints a very great deal over the course of my career, but not in many years. And there's a lot of information and a lot of intricate, you know, stuff going on. The prints for this job are probably well over 20 pages. So, and they are different layout, like each print is a different thing. And then within that set of things, there's also different floors. So I have a demolition plan, and then I have a reflected ceiling plan, and then I have a power plan, then I have a lighting plan. You know what I mean? So, but all of these things, because you can't put it all on the same print, it would be too crowded. They make a new print for each different thing, but they're all related. So you have to flip back and forth, you know, and really learn what you need to do process wise. So because of that, I'm going to be losing some of my relaxation time to make sure to ensure my success at work. I'm not sure what I would put in my accord. I think my accord would probably have to be mostly weekend focused. My weekdays it's tough for me.
I know you have a commute back and forth, and obviously sometimes, but you know, sometimes too, that, you know, when you do these reviews, it's like you go, what's important, and say, you know, can I replace this tool, the job, with a different tool that gives me more time? That's always an option. And the things people feel a lot of times feel tied in to a job. I know for years, like I started working full time when my future wife, who's now my now wife, was literally in her last year of school, and her dad thought she was a year older than she was. So he just decided that the divorce decree no longer covered her and wasn't going to pay for her last year of college.
Oh boy.
Yeah, yeah. And he was wrong. She actually finished school in 3 years. And if you know my wife, she's a smart person, so it's not too shocking, but she actually overloaded her classes. She was trying to get done. She wanted to move on. But the thing was, we actually ended up moving in together, and I ended up helping pay for the last year of college to make sure that she had. But from that time on, you know, for years, that kind of made me like the typical male breadwinner of a family, you know, much like, you know, most of the guys in my father's generation. And so, you know, the thought of leaving a job and moving to another job was really frightening because it was like, what happens if something happens to the new job? This job sucks, but, you know, it's a paycheck, you know, and the next job, maybe it's worse. I don't know. And especially when you haven't had a lot of jobs yet and you're, you know, fresher and more naive in the market, that's how corporations can kind of take advantage of you because you don't know any better. And some people end up stuck in the same job for a really long time. For a company that is not giving them reciprocating their the ethic back to the person that, you know, it's not duplicate. It's always important, you know, to sit there and evaluate, you know. And I'm not saying you call in your job and quit, but, you know, you maybe look for a job. Maybe the job isn't the problem. Maybe it's the way you're commuting isn't working. Or, you know, hey, can I shift my hours? That's what I did my last job before I quit and I started working, you know, before I started working in our small business, I quit my job. Or before I quit my job, I shifted my hours. So I started really early. I think I started at 5 or 5:30 a.m. And then with my work schedule, I think I was up by like 3 or 3:30. So I missed all of the commute times in Hartford. So like my hour long commute went to 15 to 20 minutes, you know, most of the year. And outside of the occasional incidents, but because that's literally, as I'm a 15 minute drive from where I used to work, but it would take me 45 minutes to an hour if I hit rush hour. So, you know, that in itself saved me a lot of time and heartache. So it was sometimes working with your boss, you can maybe make those kind of adjustments to your schedule to help out. And in the modern day, maybe there's a chance to do some telecommuting, depending on the type of work you do. Like if you're a heart surgeon, probably more difficult than for a computer programmer. But maybe not impossible. I don't know. Let's see. Now, one of the things when you and the people you're working with have the schedule, it's important to kind of come together to find where there's actually open periods of time, where you can make sacrifices and where you can make openings so you can present at times for these are the times where I'm free. These are the times in which you're free. You know, that's very important. You know, you have to come to agreement on those if there's anyone else involved. And if it's just with yourself, you have to sit there and really make an agreement with yourself that it's for that time and no longer. Because, you know, especially I think when I was single, the tendency would be, oh, I'm going to play EverQuest for an hour and then I'm going to go read a book. Yeah, that didn't work out too well usually. That usually worked out to a 74-hour stretch of EverQuest. you know, so, you know, you got to hold yourself accountable, you know, in here. If you can't be honest with yourself, would you be shocked that no one else finds you trustworthy? I mean, and I think the biggest important thing you have to have is a realization that life happens. Life happens. When you come up with these agreements, you know, life happens. It usually is going to take some practice for everyone involved for a couple weeks to start respecting those time limits anyway. But then, you know, it's like, for example, in my family, you know, I work with the VA health system. When they call, I have to go. I have to go in. I can sometimes work out, but especially if it's dealing with like my the damage caused to me by the military where I've been rated as disabled, I have to go, especially if it's, you know, the PNC people calling. You go when they call. When the bureaucrats call, you have to go. That's the way a government system works. And so when it's my wife's time, and we have to do this for work and for life because obviously we work together at home. So it's a double layered over. So, but if my appointment's during my wife's time, I have to verify. I need to be able to visually look at her schedule to make sure I'm not scheduling over something she has pre-existing, And hopefully, if it's something like the VA, I have a little flexibility, but not always. And then you have to communicate with them like, hey, I it's in the calendar. I put it here. We literally have three calendars between me and my wife. We have her calendar with her appointments, my calendar with my appointments, and what we call the master calendar. And these are all like Google shared calendars. And so we leave all three up so we can see who's where's Jeffrey's time, where's Kristen's time, in mapped out, and then we can see each other's appointments too. So we've caused a lot less anxiety. And wait, why'd you schedule something for that day? You know we're going to see my mom. Oh, I'm sorry, I can't go. But it leads to a lot less of those types of issues on top. So actually, there's a side benefit of coming up with a relaxation accord is you get into a lot less arguments over scheduling of stuff. Like, you know, I have to, you know, like my wife, I have to get my CPA renewed and I have to do a CPE that day. It's all day. I've had it scheduled for 9 months and now you're going to go out for coffee with a friend, you know, during my time? No way, you know, so. And with that, there's certain things that she has to do, like her health appointments, or sometimes she has a CPE, continuing education that she has to do during my time, and that's when it's available, you know. But you exchange short-term or you forgive short-term indulgences. You know, you need those escape clauses for it's okay, because sometimes life happens. Like life happened all over Michael's face during this episode.
There's been a lot of life.
A lot of life.
So I haven't quite been following the notes here. What have we covered up to here?
The escape clause.
I was about to say, I think we covered escape clause. So.
Yep. That was just where we were. Is there anything you want to go back and revisit or?
I guess you may want to write down a priority list. Mm-hmm. And I don't mean of all the priorities in your life, but when you start sitting down to talk about your relaxation, if you only have so much time and you've got a lot of things that you want to do with that mm-hmm. time, you may want to prioritize it or create a rolling schedule mm-hmm. In your accord that allows you to do those different mm-hmm. things. Like I find when I have free time, I definitely don't have enough to do all the things that I like to do because I like to do mm-hmm. a lot of things. Like I love to play video games and lately I have not been doing that at all. Mm-hmm. I haven't played in like 2-3 weeks because I've had very little free time and the free time I have had, I've been playing with cards mm-hmm. more. So, and also I've got some reading that I want
to
get done.
You like to beat metal.
I haven't done that. Well, the funny thing is when I started making knives, I had intended it to be a winter hobby, something that I could, you know. Oh,
because you can't go out instead of like hiking or something.
Right. I figured, you know, I'm going to have more time in the winter where I'm cooped up inside. So I was like, I'll do this as an indoor mm-hmm. hobby. And I find that I don't like going down to my basement to do that work during the winter. I don't know mm-hmm. why. There's no reason, like, you know, I guess just that you feel cold.
Psychological, like it's gloomy and now you're in a dark basement.
Yeah. You feel cold. And well, let's be fair. I did the lighting in my basement, so it's very bright in my basement. It is. It's actually way bright. It's funny because you look at mine next. There's slats through the wall mm-hmm. that adjoin the neighbor's storage space that's right next to mine. And his has got like just
it's
one
like a flickering
light bulb
candle compared to your side.
Right. But yeah, mine's lit up like a Christmas tree. but I don't do it. Like I don't. I was actually just thinking about it because I was putting some laundry in earlier today, and I have a steel project sitting on my bench right now. And come little, you know, we get a little deeper into spring, I'll be down there and I'll start mm-hmm. it up again.
It's funny, it's just, that's weird how life works that way. Like you come up with the plan, but you're like, mm-hmm. it doesn't work here, but it works here. Yeah,
I don't know why. It should like the wintertime would be a perfect time for me to be down there doing it, but I think
that kind of brings up a good point too, where you need to revisit this. This can't be like, okay, we've signed this and it's done for the rest of eternity. If jobs change, if there's a life situation change, you're gonna have to revisit this. If I know it's like my wife teaches classes at a university, so it gives us a natural time every semester. We just kind of go, okay, it's time. Mm-hmm. This is where the class schedule's changed. And so whatever evening she has to teach class, I got Eric all evening. That's just the way it works. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, we can divvy up the rest of the time during tax season. She gets a lot more time than I do just because she's a tax accountant. Plus, we run a business. Plus, she's a professor. She, you know, when she's doing, when the taxes are included, that's just a lot of work. You have to come up with these things, but, you know, review it every once in a while and just go out with just your spouse, you know, and work it out between you two. You know, if you have kids, you need to be a unified front, you know, against them. It's you against your kids. Don't be fooled. That's one thing my parents taught us, and my parents were jerkingly good at. I saw all my friends manipulating their parents. It drove me nuts because I tried all those tricks on my parents. Oh, mom said it was fine to go to the ball, and you'd give me $20. Let's go ask your mom. Oh, there's no need to go ask her. I take my word for it, you know. And no, none of those tricks worked because they just talked. And it sucked as a kid, but it worked out ultimately in the long run for me, probably. But yes, you know, it's, you know, you and the kids, but you have to remember too, they're human beings in your house, so they need some consideration. They need some relaxation time too. It's so crazy. You look at like the amount of schoolwork kids are given today, and you know, it's like they have kids working 8-hour shifts for kindergarten, you know, like, oh, it's horrible. Yeah. It's like they're given, and then they pile on homework on kindergartners now. You know, it's insane what they're doing these kids to try and get good test scores. They're destroying, and people are wondering why kids are so anxiety ridden today. It's school. You know, it's like, think about how you feel at work when it's busy, and it's busy season all year. They're in school now. You know, I know some really intelligent kids who are ridden with anxiety who should be cruising through school because they're like, they have 20, 30 more IQ points than I do. But it's the way school's structured now. It's really tough on them. And you need to fight and make sure your kids have relaxation time too. One, it'll help bring some sanity to your house, but it shows them respect that they're also a human being. Yes, ultimately, mom and dad have the decision-making authority, but part of that should be to share some of make sure their kids are having free time too. Don't let your schools push your kids around. Sorry. A little rant.
No, that's fine. It's a good rant.
But then ultimately, when it comes down to creating your relaxation accord as an any accord, this is Libertarian Jeff speaking here, all agreements should always be aimed to be a voluntary agreement that is a win-win for all parties involved. It means all parties win from the deal. And like Michael said, you might have to create priorities. Maybe you can't do all of the things you want to year-round, but you know, it's like maybe in spring you can go in your basement and beat on some metal. Or drums or whatever you want to beat on down there. And then in the winter, you're upstairs in books reading more or whatever it is you want to do to relax. Just make sure there's something you do to relax throughout your life, because if you overstuff your life with work and deadlines, you're going to burn out and it's not going to end pretty. It might not end devastatingly, but it will. You'll create a cycle where you'll work and burn out. And usually for most people, their work lives aren't destroyed. It usually ends up destroying their family lives, their personal lives. So be careful. Don't fall into that. It's the trap of modern man. It's where we are. It's the price of prosperity. But part of it is if you are in control of your life, if you can control your finances and your time, you know, it might not be where you want them to be, but if you can control them where they're at, you know, it's like, I have a lot of dreams I can spend money on, right? I just don't have all the money I need to do that spending yet. And that's okay, but I control where my finances are at this moment, which frees me up to do stuff like create podcasts with Michael.
And who doesn't want to do that?
Anyone beside you. You're actually my last choice, but everyone else said no.
Well, so. Yeah.
Okay.
We both know that's not true. You can make that lie all you want. I will never believe
You'll
it.
You'll never believe it. That's true. Because you're not humble like me.
No, because you told me when you asked me on.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
I'm choosing to believe your first lie.
Fair enough. Okay. So, Michael, what should the World Builders task be today? Since I wrote something illegible, I'm going to chuck it onto you.
Well, if they are finding that their free time is nil or difficult to organize, then it's time to make an accord. If you have plenty of free time and, you know, you're getting everything you want to do done, then you may not need to do this. But I know no one that I can
think of. Well, my suggestion is if you're doing that,
that falls into
that. Go to the people who are immediately around you, like that you live with, and ask them if they do, because sometimes they're getting screwed over and that might come back to bite you too. Because sometimes life is generous to one or the other. It's best to share in your generosity with those that you love. And now for the real world task. Let us know how it works out for you, right? Spend some time, put your core together. Come to facebook.com/groups/Undercroft. There are three questions. You're required to fill out the first two. The third one, you don't have to give us your email address. You can even tell us dirty, like go F off if you want to. We don't care what you say there. But the first two you have to answer. And that is a way we know you're not a spam bot and you can come into the group. And hopefully at some point we will say hello.
Hello. Hello.
So we thank you all for tuning in and we'll see you next week. Thank you so much for listening to the World Builders Anvil.
We would love it if you would share the World Builders Anvil with two of your friends.
And so would they.
If they are unfamiliar with podcasts, then you get to introduce them to the wonderful world of podcasting.
Take them to Stitcher or iTunes, or best of all, just send them to our website, www.garduel.com.
That's G-A-R-D-U-L.com.
Now strike while the mithril's hot.